Hey, we're back right here on KCHFM. We're back right here on KCHFM 89.5 on your dial. All right, I had a little, another one of my little lapses, my little dyslexic lapses that I run across here when I start pushing buttons, and I get distracted. I get to focus on something else, and then just kind of don't pay attention to what's going on here. All right, hey, I'm going to put off the stupid thing until the stupid thing. Until the next break, because I had something else here I'd rather do first. This is an article I found, and this is something I was kind of alerted to this a couple of weeks ago. I was just happened to be channel surfing, and I ran across, as I do sometimes, I went on to CNN. I like listening to Campbell Brown sometimes with her No Bias, No Bull show, because it so much speaks as to how I feel and look at liberalism, that you're going to sit there and spiel out propaganda on a regular basis and tell me that it's unbiased and it's no bull. And Campbell Brown is like one of the perfect examples of somebody who is a deconstructionist, somebody who can take the truth and deconstruct it, redefine it, and then come back and spit it out as something that it's not, and say that that's unbiased, subjective reporting. Her and Wolf Blitzer are my two favorite people on CNN. Maybe James Carville, as Dennis Miller once described, as a Muppet washed on hot. But these guys are people that I just like to watch, because they give you, these are the extremists. These are the people that you can look at and see, this is what the worst of what liberalism is about. But she had a guy on there, I think his name is Jamie, I'm going to say Robinson or Robbins or something like that. And this guy's some kind of chef from England. He's over here on a mission from God to try to get obesity eliminated from the American way of life, the American diet, that kind of stuff. A real socialist type of guy. And she was interviewing him, and the way that they were talking about it, and she was asking him, who's to blame for obesity in the nation and this, that, and the other, because that's what liberals do. Who's to blame? Because right after who's to blame, we identify somebody, and then we have to regulate it, and we have to change it, and we have to make it better, because that's what utopia is about, and that is impeding on the rights of the individual for the sake of the whole kind of thing. And I thought to myself at that moment, I said, you know what, it isn't going to be far away when the government is now going to start telling us what we have to eat, and they're going to start trying to regulate what comes into our stores and things like that, way beyond what they do now with the FDA and all this other stuff. Well, sure enough, I run across this article on Reuters by Joanne Allen, Friday, April 9th, Routine Recess, a Hit at White House Obesity Summit. And it says here, a doctor's endorsement of frequent recess breaks, and not just for kids, drew an appreciative response from experts meeting at a White House summit on childhood obesity on Friday. Dozens of child advocates, public policy experts, and doctors gathered to brainstorm ideas for First Lady Michelle Obama's campaign to wipe out child obesity in a generation. Interagency task force reviewing U.S. programs and policies on child nutrition and physical activity is due to report to President Barack Obama within the next month. The summit participants were asked to come up with 3 to 5 recommendations for the task force to consider taking to the president. And it goes on to say here that the United States spends $150 billion a year to treat obesity-related conditions. The costs are projected to almost double over the next decade and will account for a fifth of overall health care spending. There's your buzzword, guys. White House Budget Director Peter Orszag said. So now what we're going to have is we're going to have the government, I'm making a prediction here, and you watch what happens. Obviously, this is Michelle Obama's pet plan or pet program, and what she's going to do with it, and it's going to be one of these things where Barack Obama's going to do it because he wants to appease his wife, who is as much a socialist as he is, as much of a criminal as he is. And she comes out of the Mayor Daley's office. That's where she worked. That's where she cut her political teeth. And he's got to give her something to do so that she feels important. And here's the point. With the health care bill and everything that's going to start coming down about the cost, when people really start realizing how much this plan, this atrocity is going to cost, and its inability to do what they say it's going to do, well, one of the things we're going to be told in one way or another is that our health care is going to be based on what we eat. And we're going to start being told that if we eat certain foods, and if it's determined that we're living a certain type of lifestyle, that our medical costs are going to be reduced, or we have to pay more for it, or we have to be taxed for it, or whatever. The problem we're going to have with this, when you live in low-income society, a segment of society like we have in this country, where people eat at McDonald's every single day because it's all they can afford, or people like their fried food down in the South, and their collard greens, and their pork rinds, and everything else, how are you going to do that? Well, those of us who pay taxes will have to pay more to subsidize those who don't have the discipline to eat properly. And then those of us who do have the discipline, well, I don't have the discipline. I'm not a disciplined eater. You can tell by looking at me. I'm not worried about calories on a regular basis. But the whole point of it is this. If I want to be fat, I should be fat. It's my right to be fat if that's what I choose. If I want to take on the risks of being overweight and all the things that come with it, that is my prerogative. That is my right as a U.S. citizen. And now to have people start coming at me, and it's going to happen, and I know that you guys are saying, hey, the government's not going to do this. Barack Obama isn't going to do this. Well, yeah, that's what they said about the health care thing. Remember, there wasn't going to be an abortion, but the big issue came down to abortion funding. You know, that kind of thing. Oh, there's not going to be death panels, but we're going to cut Medicare. You know, don't tell me that this guy is going to not do these things. He is going to do them. And this is going to be one of his pitches. We need to cut the budget. We need to minimize the expense. And so what are we going to do? We're going to start telling you what you can eat. Now that's going to affect us economically, because now they're going to start coming after companies. You have to produce things a certain way. It can only have certain things in it. Can't have, just like gasoline out here in California. Our gas is 30 to 40% cents higher on a gallon because we have all these special things that have to be done to it because people are afraid of a little smog. This is coming down the pipe, guys. It's just another way of controlling our lives. It really has nothing to do. And here's the point. This is what really grabs me. They're going to do it in a generation. Everything with Obama is now. Let's do it now. Let's do it now. Let's not think it through. Let's not worry about the consequences. Let's just do it. So it's on its way, guys. It's coming down the pipe. Be ready for it. That Big Mac may cost you a tax surcharge in the future. All right, we're going to go to another break. When we come back, we will continue. We'll get into stupid Stupak as soon as we get back.